golfers. You struggle with big slice, little slice, uncontrollable, one where you get up to a hole and you're just, please don't go out of bounds, please don't go out of bounds to the right, and you hit it and you're like, I don't know why, I have no idea what I did different. Well, I'm going to tell you a few things. The root cause is, you got to understand what the root cause of slicing, okay? So if I have a slice, right, my club face is open, okay? I don't care if your ball starts left and still curves to the right, or right, it's still open, okay? It's open to your swing path, which is going to cause that spin to the right, okay? That's just the laws of golf, okay? So when you learn to close your club face, you'll learn to fix a lot of it, okay? So look at some of my drills on that. I'm also going to tell you this, and within a couple days, I'm going to have my course out on skillets, on slicing. It's a cure-all fix for it, but I want to show you something here that may help you here with a drill. Figure eight drill, okay? Now, so I have this plane set up here about the same angle as my club. Okay, see that? So I think it's a 7-iron or something. Okay, so 62 degrees maybe, something like that. 60, no, okay, 6-iron or 60, yeah. So, okay, but anyways, you want to set it up about right there. We're going to get up to a ball here. Now, you can see how I have one going down parallel to my target line here on the ground as well. Always practice with that bullets. Now, if you are a slicer, what do you do most likely? I don't care what your backswing looks like. What happens is the downswing is this, usually with a wide open club face, like that, right? You end up on your back foot or something trying to catch up to it, something like that. All because of this club face, okay? Now, I say all because of this club face, but there's still a few other things up here that have to be messed with, okay? So, figure eight drill is this. This is, if you really want to get rid of it, work on this drill, guys. And I'm not going to say it's easy, okay? We're going to go like this. So here's this right here. I have it set up like that. Now, I don't have this set up that hard. I'm going to set it up. I should set it kind of like this. Now, for you guys, just grab an alignment stick. I know you all have them in your bag to take to the range and practice with. Shove one in the ground or put them into, ball baskets. Just arrange it so it fits in those holes upside down. So you need the right angle you want, okay? And then this, you're just going to have to adjust, okay, until you find out where you want it. It's usually about 3 feet out to the right. Now, we're going to do figure eight, so we're going to come out here, outside, and then I want you to come back underneath it, okay? So, this is going to be complete opposite of what you normally do. So, here to here, okay? So, here to here. You set them, guys, and then you start hitting them on a tee. Don't hit it hard. You see how hard I was swinging? Just do it like that. Go from here. But look how open you'll get to it. I mean, by the time you come here, you're going to start finding out your lower body's closing this club face for you, too. Okay? It's not just your hands. And usually, what you guys are doing this is back foot on your hands here like this, and you pick that foot up. Okay, so I have a bunch of other drills too. I'm just closing this club face and I'm checking out my stuff. Go to Linktree, linktr.ee/EJS Golf. That has everything of mine listed on there. Or you can also find it through EJSGolf.com. Guys, Eric Schulberg, thank you. This is your slice fix drill.